Okay, so the stream will begin shortly. The game is just having trouble loading it. Sorry for the wait, and while waiting, I'll put the music back on. So I'm not sure what's going on with the loading software. The stream again will be starting shortly. So welcome to this stream. We have the Arriva Trains Class 175. We are going to be doing a stopping service to Bristol Parkway from. Oh my god, this is the park, guys. I'll say something wrong. In Welsh, it's something difficult to say, unless of course you're Welsh, which I'm not. But in other words, Newport. We're at Newport at the moment. And so we are going to be making our way down to Bristol Parkway, also stopping at, I'm not sure which direction we're coming from there, so I'm not completely sure where we're going in the, so now let's open the doors and get ready for the journey ahead. Okay, so the doors are shut now. Departure time of 8:01. It's quite a good one. It's a shame that it's going to disappear after a while. And I believe the Arriva trains have stopped operating. So Train Simulator decided that they are going to withdraw all their stuff. So I bought this in sale that they were sailing all off. worth it quite a bit. So quite a nice pack. I mean, like, I don't see why they've withdrawn it. After all, there's a lot of heritage and steam stuff on there, which obviously doesn't get used anymore unless you're counting the Isle of Wight, which basically is still quite heavily frequently used. So it is quite a nice map. So as we've just come from Bristol Parkway, no, we haven't come from Bristol Parkway, we've come from Newport in Wales. We go down to Bristol Parkway, Shelton's Bar, quite nice. It's a shame. It's a really nice place. I think the Arriva liveries are unlike any other. They're quite iconic, so Arriva is quite an important company in the UK. So obviously they operate all the buses in London. They're owned by DB, I don't know how to pronounce their full name, which is the German train company, which is also quite a large company. So the actual livery of Arriva is quite different, quite iconic. So the big red buses and the green buses as well. So not forgetting the trains in Wales. I don't know where else they operate. I don't know if it is just only Wales. I'll have to look that up. So this is quite an interesting place, Usk. I've been to Usk before, it's quite nice. I believe Usk Castle is there, which doesn't surprise me considering it is Usk. So speed limits on this line are quite interesting, as they're constantly changing. So 75, 90, back there it's 30, always changing. I mean, sometimes it's nice, sometimes it's not, because obviously transferring a train can get a little tight. Sometimes the train that I'm driving isn't very fast accelerating. This train's quite a fast accelerator. I mean, it is a diesel, so it won't be a fast, it's an electric. and the train is like, I've driven this train once before, I think. I can't remember when. It was in a different simulator. It wasn't as good as this. Some people say this game's graphics are bad. I challenge them to find a better one. Yeah, I'm not that serious when I say I challenge you to find a better game and better graphics. But if you do, then we'll take a look at it and potentially debate. One of the things I've noticed about these trains is that the AWS bell only rings on the inside of the train, which makes it incredibly difficult to drive. Considering that all I get is a little bit here. And that is literally it. Okay, so I believe audio should be a bit better now, because I just watched a little bit of the live stream I'm doing, and I realised you can barely hear me over the train, so this should be a bit better, hopefully. I'm going to re-watch this in a second, sorry about that. Or did anybody else just see that man spawn in there? It's quite interesting. I've never seen people spawn. That is one of the elements of the game that is not as good. I suppose they have to spawn in somewhere, so That's where. Arriva Trains is another locomotive that the game came with. Not the actual game, but this route did come with the Freightliner train. One of the routes I play on, I noticed that one of the tunnels, I think it is this tunnel. This tunnel is a peculiar tunnel, as you look at it from a certain angle, I can't get that angle back for some reason. But it turns out it's literally just a piece of black all the way through that tunnel. And this train has very, very bad interior lighting, I have noticed. Which is not really very nice. And this is all I get to see in the tunnel. See the track there, see the glint of it. This is a very long tunnel, I don't remember it being this long. I don't know where it ends. A bit haunting. If it at all ends. That just looked like something out of a sci-fi movie, with the blue light and that. Interesting. And just going through that thing again. Oh look, here it is. That's where it ends. We're over here. And we end over there. Lovely. And then we get the 90 mile an hour speed limit, which is just absolutely wonderful. And then another tunnel. things I do wish they'd bring into the game is allowing me to sit in the seats in the tunnel. It's one of my favourite things when I'm on a train. Being in a tunnel, in a seat. Really quite fun. I like the underground so much. Alas, the light at the end of the tunnel. Years since I've seen the light of day. I'm going to ramp this train up to full speed, which is a 90 mile an hour speed limit just there. So we're just up here. Just at the mouth of the tunnel. Let's see if we can stay in the seat position. We like this material. Plus the lights are on in here. Bizarre, I found the cab light. Great. Let's see what else we got. Windscreen wipers. Instrument lights. Don't know what that does. Not the instruments, but how to get that to work. Doesn't seem to work. I can grab it, but it doesn't work. It appears that there's a station coming up, which I don't know how to pronounce, just like the German video which I released. I don't know how to pronounce them. And we are going way too fast for the approaching station. I think we might miss it. Oh, the emergency brake is going to save us. I'm sure of that. Question is, will it stop us before or after the station? Okay, I'm just going to keep going at full speed at this rate, but we're not stopping. After all, this doesn't have to be a stopping service, but it already is technically. The game's too smart for that. It won't let me do that. That's a disappointment. We're back. to a new tunnel coming up just in the distance there, and also one back there, just what we need. Test it out with cab lights, see if that makes a difference. Cab light has made a difference in cab, but the headlights still don't seem to be making any difference to the outside view. Then we'll be out of Patchway's tunnel and into Patchway the actual station. Patchway platform 1. We're not too long. Kind of difficult to see until we're actually there. As you can sort of see the wheels of the tunnel speeding past us, going at 64 miles an hour, which isn't fast for a train. Maybe a bit fast for some cars, depends which car you're driving. Go up to 100 miles an hour, some can go up to only 10. Ones that go up to only 10 are not road legal. I don't think they are. They shouldn't be about to be. Just going around houses. I'm gonna slow down in advance, because otherwise that could end in a horrible demise over at Patchway. The game's lagging at the moment. Frames per second just going down. Frame rate, don't lose it. There we go, we've recalculated our frame rate. Let's see if we can stop the station. We've done it, and luckily all the doors have opened. Sometimes they don't all open because they're not on the platform. All the doors are open. Next station is Bristol Parkway. earlier while I was testing out this route, I actually got caught out by the AWS, which just went on just a second ago. It really bugs me when that happens. It really does. So that's the end of that route. We've arrived at Bristol Park. Let's go any further. So while we wait, I'm going to put the music back on and load up another route in Wales with Arriva Trains. We'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. Today we have the first Cardiff Bay service of the day. Final task is to head to the train wash, not forgetting the 3 mile per hour speed limit before heading into platform 2 at Cardiff Queen Street. This isn't the first time I've done this one. I had a go at it earlier, but unfortunately I went through that train wash over there at 10 miles an hour and I failed the mission. This time we're going to go for it at 3 miles an hour. And hopefully we do not fail the mission. This is a class 143 going to Cardiff Queen Street. This is a train that does not come with the other, with the Arriva Trains South Wales route. This is part of the DMU add-on. So, oh god, where is it going at 12 miles an hour? So that the DMU add-on comes with a DMU, which is the class 143, and I already had the other one. I can't remember which one it is, but it comes with, if you do not already have it, it comes with the train and two skins for it. I already had it, so for me it just came with two skins. If you already have the HST, this South Wales pack, as you just saw that HST go back by there, comes with the GWR skin. Now this is probably one of the most annoying things in train sim, which is the train washers. One of them is because you go in the same way you come out. So you go in dirty, if you're dirty or clean, and you come out dirty or clean. But, I mean, like, it is a good concept. I do like the idea of having a train wash in the game. I think that's quite cool. The driver here, he wasn't too pleased. Maybe we should put the windscreen wipers on. Just a second while we do that in the train wash. As you can see, it's a 3 mile an hour speed limit. Now, I don't know why it's only 3 miles an hour. I think it should be something like 4 or 5, something easier to manage. Now it's 10. Well, I know that this train is capable of going at 15 miles an hour on gear 1, so I'm going to keep it at that, otherwise we are going to go over the speed limit and potentially fail this mission. thing I do like about this particular train is that there's no people in it yet. Now, I also have Doncaster Works, which is kind of hard to put on YouTube. I don't know if I could drive there. I also have Doncaster Works, which is kind of hard to put on YouTube. I'm trying to figure out how to put a video on, because it's not really got many missions, more just moving stuff around. It's not that interesting, although, like, it would be a good live stream, I do. It would take a long time. But this train has no passengers. However, in Doncaster Works, when you look into the discarded locomotives and the carriages and stuff, there's people sat in them. And I always just ponder to myself why they didn't think to make something else to have inside of the yard, because there's people in there and you're sending them to a scrap line, so it's not very intelligent of you if you do. Obviously the mission will fail if you don't, but yeah. So that is the other locomotive. It's the enough. It's the class 158. Now, when you buy the pack just for the class 158, it does also come with TransPennine, Northern, Central Trains, and another one, which, to be honest, is not the nicest skin in the world. In my opinion, it's probably one of the most horrible skins I've ever seen. But the Arriva Trains Wales, and it also comes with the First Great Western with the Arriva one. I don't know why, but it does, so I'm assuming that is service operating. So I quite like that, those skins that it comes with, because I also have the GWR mainline, so I can now use that on the GWR mainline without it looking absolutely out of place. Now, before anybody says in the comments, I didn't just go past the station. I did, but I didn't need to stop there. So this train will be basically just going to Cardiff Queen Street, then back to Cardiff Bay, then turn around, back to Cardiff Queen Street. Quite simple. So this train, one of the things that's quite unique, which I've never seen in a train before, is the door. So I'll show you when load up the train with people. These lines here, they stay where they are, because there's a... No, they don't. They fold away. There's a step there. Now these doors cut up half of it so that the door can fit over the step. I think that's quite unique of this train. I've never seen it anywhere else, so... Let me know in the comments if you've heard of it anywhere else. But I have never seen that personally on a train before. Part of the line I don't like, because it always makes me think, am I going to go head first into this train, or am I going to switch tracks? Obviously I know I'm going to switch tracks, but I don't want to go head first into that train. No, that would be catastrophic. the doors have a piece cut out, and when they fall back, you'll see that piece come back. And I think that's quite cool. So we wait for the doors to close. Look, that piece is just folded back out. Oh, hello. The driver you're taking over the service and taken ill. Oh dear. Switch cabs, pressing control and plus. Okay. This is quite an interesting thing. Never heard of that before. Okay, there we go. We've switched cabs now. I believe we just go in the other direction. Oh, am I meant to load more passengers? Now I load more passengers yet again. I've switched the lights around now. There we go. We've got a driver at each end. Lovely. Really happy with his job. Good for him. Cardiff Bay. On that end, that's the way we're facing. Cardiff Queen Street on this end. That's the way that end's facing. If we were to go that way, we'd just end up hitting that buffer over there. Again, with the fancy doors. Bits cut out of it. Okay. This is also a very slow train. Well, it's not slow, it can go quite fast. It is a pacer as well. But the line isn't making us or letting us go that fast at all. Let's have a look at the interior. A nice green interior. Slightly disturbing. Interesting. Okay, it's slightly worrying. I'm really quite concerned. Okay. Well, it's nice scenery as well. Must admit. And what I might do one day is film a video of literally just loads and loads of train seat views. Not all of the trains I have, because some of them are slightly off focus, but this one would be quite nice. Assuming it doesn't look weird, we are on a bridge. Sometimes it does look a bit weird. I watch a YouTuber and when I don't know, I can't remember what it's called, the channel, but whenever the train goes over a bridge and he's in the seat view, it just looks really weird. Looks like you're floating. Unless, of course, the railing's there. Yeah. Back then, where there was no versions, the railing just looks super weird. They're above the world. Okay, we're approaching Cardiff Bay now. I like how the trees and like they're not symmetrical. They do all sort of look similar. I also like how they detail the back gardens. It's quite nice. There was one back there with a football net, and there was a trampoline earlier on the screen. Quite nice. Yeah, this is Cardiff Bay. Now, in case you're wondering, where is the bay? Now, I can go over to the bay. I can't remember which way it is now. Aha! Ah, here it is. No, that's not the bay. It's one way or another. And I'll follow this river. Okay, I've lost my chances to find Cardiff Bay. There somewhere. Okay, we switch cabs again. Okay, going forward. There we go. These trains do look like the buses though, this particular one. The doors operate the same way, they have the yellow handles, the livery looks surprisingly similar. Obviously not the buses, but the livery is the same. Uber, put them on the side. Quite nice. So I believe this will be our last stop at Cardiff Green Street. Yeah, so we're going to Cardiff Green Street where the stream will put. Cardiff is a nice place to end the stream. Indeed, indeed. A nice stretch this. One thing I do like about Trains and Rosa, which I do recommend you buy this game is unlike any other. This is not, I'm not being paid to do this. I'm not that popular. So, massive. If you enjoy Trains, you get this game. There's loads and loads of routes, not so many American routes. If you're going for American Trains, I don't recommend this game. But I'm not really into that sort of stuff. I mean, there is also this Norfolk Southern N line. I haven't really figured out whether that is a UK or American. Because last time I recall, Norfolk is a place in the UK, but the trains are also very American, so I'll have to look that up as well. Now, we're going back to Cardiff Green Street, where the stream will, unfortunately, end. Another video which I will post is basically just this train, except in the Isle of Wight, as that was before I paid for this map, and it hadn't downloaded yet, so I thought why not just film this train on the Isle of Wight, as it was the quickest thing to upload, and it did look really good. So I will post that maybe tomorrow, not today, we've had some content for today, so tomorrow will be the day. Providing it gets processed before then. So thank you for watching the stream. I appreciate your presence. If there is at all anyone watching this live, I don't think there is. Yeah. Nope. If you're watching it, please do comment. And I passed the signal of danger, so I failed it anyway. So thank you for watching. Have a great Easter. Thanks for going and celebrating Easter. And good night.